In this interest rate futures, we are typically looking at a couple of terms before we get into the calculations and all. Couple of terminologies need to be comfortable with. One is the day count conventions. See, these all will come into picture, especially when I am doing a sell-off of my bonds in the middle. I have purchased a bond. I want to sell it off, probably in the middle before the maturity period. There are a lot of bonds that are traded also. We have seen in the list. So I want to sell off the bond somewhere in the middle. If I have to sell off the bond, let's say the bond is purchased on 1st Jan, the coupon is being paid on 1st July, right? And I am thinking of selling off the bond on 1st September. I want to sell off. So the next coupon will be paid on 1st Jan. This is the flow. Now I am thinking of selling off the bond on 1st September itself. Now the logic is, if I sell off on 1st September, the other party who has purchased it, he will receive the coupon, the next coupon, the coupon that is going to be declared on 1st Jan. He would be the recipient of that. I would not be the recipient, right? But if you look at it in slightly more detail, for this 4 months of holding, he is receiving the entire coupon, whatever is getting declared. But the 2 months of holding here, I'm not receiving any coupon here, because coupon is an amount that goes to the owner. And directly he is the owner, the new guy is the owner, so he will receive the entire coupon. So what we are simply saying is, if at all I have to sell off the bond today, I should add up this interest also for this 2 period, whatever I am supposed to receive as an interest for this 2 month period, I should add it up, put it as a part of the selling price. If see, that's the only way I will get the coupon worth of this too, because once the other party is purchasing the bond, he will receive the entire coupon. But logically speaking, I should receive the half of the coupon, or at least 2 months worth of the coupon, because I have held it for that many months. Or assume that you have sold it on 15th December. Even then also, the other party only will receive the coupon. Just by holding it for 15 days, he should not be eligible to receive the entire coupon. So that is where what we are saying is, you will try to find out the interest, which is accumulated between the last coupon payment date and the settlement date. Today we are settling it off. So if I am trying to find out the coupon between the last settlement, last coupon date, if I am trying to find out that worth of the coupon between the last coupon date and the date on which I am selling off the bond, because that much of coupon should come to me, that is what we are calling as accrued interest. The interest which got accrued but not yet paid. It will be paid only on 1st Jan. But I am disposing it out before 1st Jan. So that portion of the interest which was not paid but it came up is what we are calling as accrued interest. And simply what we are saying is, whatever is that accrued interest, there are different ways of computing the accrued interest using the various day count conventions. Logically speaking, what is that we have to put? Number of days. See, when I say, probably if I am saying, I am saying 2 months. 2 months is what I have accumulated out of the 6 months. So I may say the accrued interest is simply, if the interest is $6, if the coupon is $6, then probably I am saying 6 into 2 by 6, which is $2 belong to me. So what are we saying in computation of the accrued interest? number of days from the last coupon payment date to the total number of days between the two coupon payment dates. That is what is the time period that I would be entitled to receive. Now, that numerator and denominator, number of days from the last coupon to settlement divided by the number of days between two coupon. Different instruments compute those two things in different, that computation of the number of days is done differently by different instruments. The three different ways that are available in the market are actual to actual, actual by actual, which means so let's say, if you are simple logics, last coupon date 1st July, right? I'll take just a quick example. Last coupon date is 1st July. We are selling it off on 1st September. The next coupon date is 1st Jan. Right? If I'm going by actual mechanism, so numerator, which is the difference between these two, is in actual number of days. The denominator, which is the difference between these two, is also in actual number of days. So what is my number of days here? Probably this minus this is the actual number of days of the numerator. And this minus this is the actual number of days of the denominator. Some 0.336, whatever is the coupon, into 0.3369 belongs to me. Because actual number of days between the settlement period and the last coupon payment date divided by the actual number of days between the two coupon payment dates. That is what is the percentage of amount that gets as accrued interest for the person who is settling it off in the middle. The second convention, this is what is the computation that is typically applicable with treasury bonds. Now, the other convention that is the present is a 30 by 360 convention, which is for a municipal bonds and corporate bonds. What are we saying in that case? Find out the completed months. So, every first is 1 month, irrespective of 30 days, 31 days, whatever it is. Every first or every same date is a 1 month. So, because you have taken the 1st July, 1st August is 1 month. It's like 30 days. Whether it is 31 or 29, it doesn't matter. It's 1 month. It's taken as 30 days. One completed month is taken as 30 days. So, 1st July when you are starting, 1st August is some 30 days. 1st September is another 30. So, 60. So, your settlement is happening in 60 days. So, it is taken in terms of month and part of it. So, it simply, in that convention, it goes as 60 by 180. Because the 1st Jan is taken as 6 months. The first is 30 days. Any same date repeating, it's taken as 30 days. So, probably if it had settled on 3rd September instead of 1st September, you would take it as 62 days. 60 days up to 1st September. We won't count how many exact days. One same date repeating is 30 days over. Another time it repeats, another 30 days over. Apart from that, any excess comes, you just add up those days. So here we are saying in this convention, I'll get only 0.3331. Whereas the third convention is actual by 360. So, denominator is computed in terms of months. So, in this case, my denominator is 180 only. But the numerator is actuals. Numerator is actuals, which is the difference between these two, divided by denominator, which is 180. So, this comes out as 0.344. So, these are the three conventions that are available to compute your accrued interest. So different kinds of instruments.